This is Nick Schifrin, and I've been reporting all day on what experts describe as the audacious, unprecedented, unbelievable in scope, just to use some of their words, apparent attack on Lebanese Hezbollah. So what happened is that earlier this morning, some 2,700 people in Lebanon were injured by exploding pagers. Experts I speak to say that there appears to have been explosives put into all of these pagers during the production process, or maybe after they were produced, which suggests that the supply chain for the pagers was infiltrated by someone who wanted to do Hezbollah harm. Now, Hezbollah blamed Israel. Israel has not said anything publicly. I asked a senior Israeli official whether this official knew anything about who did this, and I received an emoji, a shrug of the shoulders. So Israel is not saying anything. But the impact is quite large. As I said, 2,700 is a lot of people. For Hezbollah, that is simply a lot of members of the organization to be injured. And the impact psychologically is going to be high. Across southern Lebanon, across southern Beirut, these pagers exploded. That means that thousands of people were affected, thousands of families were affected, families of these members, and they will put pressure on Hezbollah to respond. And the death of at least one civilian, one girl, highlights that whoever did this clearly knew the possibility of civilian casualties, and the emphasis was not on that. The emphasis was on whether they could have the greatest impact on Hezbollah itself. The context for this is extremely high tension along the Israeli-Lebanese border. Just last night, in fact, at 5 a.m., just hours before this apparent attack, the Israeli cabinet released a statement saying that one of their official war aims was to return residents who've been displaced from northern Israel since October the 8th. Some 60,000 residents have been displaced. And that came a few hours after Yoav Gallant, the defense minister, declared that diplomacy was dead between Israel and Hezbollah. That diplomacy has been led by Amos Hochstein, a senior advisor of President Biden. And he, according to a senior administration official I spoke to, urged Israel not to escalate. That was yesterday. And today we get these exploding pagers, which analysts say present two strategic options for the parties. One is that Hezbollah doesn't want to go to war, and Iran doesn't want Hezbollah to go to war. So the thinking on this side is that Hezbollah would be restrained and understand that Israel is quite serious about returning its residents back to the north. But the other analysts I say that's frankly naive, that this is so embarrassing, so shocking, so audacious, that Hezbollah, of course, will have to respond. And not only that, they'll have to respond in a way that they have not responded before. And that suggests an escalation, which, of course, will be met by an Israeli escalation. And that's the fear tonight, that we're on a real precipice of escalation, the very escalation that the U.S. has been trying to avoid.